One of the great things about indefinite integrals is whenever you think you've got the right answer, you can actually verify before, writing it down on a test or submitting it for homework or something like that. You can actually verify if it's actually correct or not. So you know, it doesn't make it any easier to find the answer, but it at least makes it very clear whether the answer that you have is either right or wrong, so you know ahead of time. So the idea is, if it's not right, then you can go back and tweak it and see where your mistake was. So here's how it works. If you're taking an indefinite integral and you think this is the answer, well, what does a antiderivative mean? Well, by definition, it means if you take the derivative of your supposed antiderivative, it should come back to your original function. And so that's a great way of checking to see if your indefinite integral is correct. You can just differentiate your answer just on some scratch paper and see if it comes back to the original integrand of your indefinite integral. So here's a real easy example. Let's say you're going to integrate 2x, right? And so you think the integral is x squared plus c, but maybe we're not really sure. We'll just put, kind of play dumb for this one. So what we could do is we could differentiate x squared, right? Really no reason to differentiate the c. The c is going to go to zero anyways, but when you differentiate the x squared, we get 2x, right, from taking a derivative, which matches your original integrand. So yeah, we must have done it correctly. All right, now, so I've got two examples here. Here's the first one. It's kind of a uglier integral, integral of 3 over 2 root 3x plus 1 dx. And so I worked this one before I started the video, and I think this is the answer. Maybe I'm going to throw a little twist in here. And then I also did another example where I integrated 2 cosine x dx as cosine squared x plus c. Now one of these is incorrect, right? But I'm not going to mention which one. You might can tell, but I want to see which one of these is the right answer and which one's the wrong answer here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take each of these guys and I'm going to differentiate them and see which one was right and which one was wrong. So we'll start with A here. All right, so if we took the derivative of, I'll just go ahead and rewrite it, 3x plus 1 to the 1/2 power. That's what a square root is equivalent to. Then chain rule, right? This is a chain rule problem. We bring the 1/2 down times 3x plus 1 to the minus 1/2. And then because of the chain rule, we'd follow that with a 3, which comes from the derivative of the inside. Okay, rewrite all that. Looks like we'd have a big fraction. In the denominator, we'd have a 2. And then this negative exponent would bring this term down to the denominator, 3x plus 1. And then the 1/2 power would make a square root. And then we still have this 3 up here in the numerator. And so if we compare this with our original integrand right here, we say, hey, yeah, it's the same thing. So without a shadow of a doubt, this is correct. This has to be the correct answer. Okay. So now, other than just by process of elimination, something must not be quite right about this. This is a common mistake students make. They see a power in front of a trig function like this, and they want to add 1 to the exponent or do something silly, thinking it's like a power rule and just not paying attention. But if we didn't realize that, we could take this guy and take the derivative with respect to x of cosine squared x. And the derivative, this will be a chain rule problem, bring the 2 down, copy the inside, and then followed by the derivative of the inside, which would make negative sine x. And then we quickly realize, whoops, that's not the same as this guy back here. So what do we do based off of this information? We say, well, okay, that obviously wasn't right. So let's erase it. Let's figure out where our mistake was. Then we look a little harder at it and we say, oh, okay, I see what I was supposed to do here. I made a mistake. This 2 should come outside the integral being a constant. And so we're really integrating 2, well, 2 times the integral rather of just the cosine function alone. And then I say, oh, okay, yeah, the integral of cosine, yeah, that would be sine x. So we have for a final answer 2 sine x plus c. So granted, I'll admit these two examples are a little bit on the simpler side, but you can still see how this idea would be very helpful if you had some big nasty integral and you think you did it right, but you had all these different rules or u substitution or rewriting or foiling or, you know, doing all these different things. Just take a 30 seconds and on some scratch paper, take the derivative of your answer and see if it comes back to whatever your original integrand is.